Kansas Governor Laura Kelly is well on her way to being protected against the coronavirus. She rolled up her sleeve and got her first shot of a vaccine on live TV earlier this evening. Until now, the state has concentrated on vaccinating healthcare workers. Governor says her shot kicks off a larger plan to vaccinate certain Kansas officials so that state government can keep running in this pandemic. State of Kansas, by the way, now works with a Kansas City research lab for mobile testing and even distributing the vaccine. MRI Global designed these mobile labs seen here for the state health department. They can run on generators if they have to, which could help people in rural parts of the state. Governor Kelly says so far Kansas has received about 159,000 vaccine doses, with another 24,000 on the way soon. The state does not have an exact number of how many people have gotten their first doses of the vaccine because there's a delay in reporting. Missouri Governor Mike Parson, meanwhile, says 66,000 people have gotten their first dose of a vaccine in the Show Me State, including healthcare workers, along with long-term care residents and staffers. Today, the governor was asked about hospitals reporting vaccine shortfalls compared to what they were initially promised.
There is a plan in place, so if you want the vaccination and you can handle the containments of it and you can handle the amount of doses, we want you to have it because we want it in people's arms. That's where we want it. So we're doing everything we can. So again, I think as those vaccines come in, one of our priorities is make sure somebody's utilizing just as quick as we can. So those numbers are going to continue to go up.
Governor Parson says the people who got the first dose of the vaccine will begin the process of getting their second dose next week. Today, one local assisted living facility made a major move in the coronavirus fight. Midwest Health held its first vaccinations in the metro at Homestead of Lenexa. Staffers with CVS administered the shots. Residents and their families couldn't be happier. Say it's a long-awaited step toward reuniting with loved ones.
This is really huge, and you know, I feel like now we can see the light at the end of the tunnel.
The more people that get the vaccine, the quicker it'll happen.
Now, vaccination dates haven't been set for the other Midwest Health facilities in Johnson County, Kansas, but organizers expect them to be scheduled soon. Tonight, Kansas City, Missouri health officials report 128 new coronavirus cases and no new deaths. They make up for part of the nearly 700 new cases reported across our 9-county metro. The average number of daily new hospitalizations in the metro is trending downward over the last week. A new coronavirus variant first found in the UK is now popping up in Southern California, Colorado, and even other countries. Medical experts say this variant appears to be more transmissible but not more deadly. They also say the new vaccines we've been talking about should be effective in fighting it off. The head scientist of Operation Warp Speed says coronavirus vaccinations are behind. The numbers are much lower than what officials hope to have had by this time. More than 14 million vaccine doses have been distributed in the U.S. so far, but only 2.1 million doses have been administered. Organizers say right now they're working to address a delay in the reporting process. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell appears to have shut the door on quickly passing more stimulus money for Americans. Tonight, he attacked a bill passed by the House that would boost direct payments from $600 to $2,000. He also blasted Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders for threatening to hold up a vote to override President Trump's veto of the National Defense Authorization Act.
Our colleague says he will slow down this vital bill unless he gets to muscle through another standalone proposal from Speaker Pelosi that would add roughly $500 billion to the national debt, which does not align with what President Trump has suggested and which has no realistic path to quickly pass the Senate.
Senator Sanders has pushed to delay the defense bill vote as a way to urge McConnell to vote on the House's standalone stimulus bill. We'll let you know what happens.